What's going on, everybody? It is a beautiful winter day, and on that note, we are just going to put this in the snow mode because it is getting slippery. All right, there we go. So, I'm a Mecca. This is Driven Hard Range Rover, and I figured I'd do a quick my thoughts on the last year and a bit I've had the Range Rover Sport. It's been just over a year. I've driven it 58,000 kilometers. Driven it to Mexico and back. I'm in Canada. This is going to be my first full winter with it because we were down in Mexico during the last winter. So this will be my first full winter with it. So I ordered some winter tires. They should be in hopefully this week. I'm going up to play on the mountain a little bit. Up the Coquihalla here during it's supposed to be a heavy snowstorm, but this is nothing. So this is kind of disappointing. I was kind of looking forward to this. But I wanted to offer you a couple of my thoughts, what it's been like, issues I've had, would I do it again, what would I change? And that's really it. I do want to do more of an in-depth, all the options and everything I could have, and the options I would get again and the ones I wouldn't get at a different video. We'll do this for right now. Alright, so, where do I begin? Well, I ain't gonna hide it. I do love it. I absolutely adore this thing. Having the Range Rover Sport over the last year or so, I picked it up in May of 2019. It's November 2020. It's been an absolute blast. I've loved every single moment of it, and absolutely no regrets. It's been solid, it's been bulletproof in terms of reliability, a couple little hiccups here or there, but was it my fault? Was it, you know, reliability issues? We don't really know, all right? But, even with snow mode, you gotta take it easy in the snow. It is just super wet. Hopefully you guys can see that on the video. It's just super wet and slushy out. But, it's been, I just love it. Like, I've been waiting to do something like this up in the snow. Like, since the day I got it. Driving on concrete's boring, it's, you know what I mean? Right? That's just like driving a Nissan Leaf. Kill me now, right? This is exciting. I was just on a forest road a little back there. I don't know if that video might or might not be up. It might be on my Instagram. Go check that out. And, this is just awesome. Being able to do stuff like this. The Range Rover has just been, it's been phenomenal. It's great in the city. It's even better on the highway when you just open it up. If you do get one, get it tuned, because this has just over 600 horsepower and the throttle response is so much more responsive. With the tune, it actually more, your fuel economy increases. However, I'm just gonna chill and follow these guys for a bit. However, your driving style will change. So it kind of balances out your fuel economy savings there. But so one thing that I have noticed is when you're driving in snow mode, the throttle is so heavy. It really, especially when traction control kicks in, when it can feel that you're slipping right there, when the truck feels like it's slipping, and traction control has to kick in, the throttle almost is like pushing you out. Like it's such a unique feeling. Very, very cool. We do have chain ups for commercial vehicles, so that means with the steepest part, the smasher, is coming up here, and it is steep as fuck. So that's where all the trucks usually spin out. I'm just hoping they don't close anything while I'm up here and stuck for an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Who knows? Because there's no other way down. uphill. So we have traction. The highway opens up a little bit up here. So hopefully we can. I think it's just a car that's in front of these two pickups. It's kind of pulling up the line here.
50 slamming on the brakes. Does it just slide?
That's where you want winter tires.